12 years ago, Rosa Rodrigo took a wrong turn when she was pulling out of a shopping center parking lot.
Well, a little scared because I didn't remember where I came from or where I was supposed to be going.
After that initial moment of panic, things got worse. Rosa had trouble getting dressed.
I don't remember anything.
Remembering her favorite recipes. She started repeating herself.
And I see every now and again, she'll be walking on her way to do something and then suddenly stop because she can't remember where she was going or what it was that she was doing.
Rosa is taking medications to try and blunt these symptoms. She also signed up for a clinical trial that could help unlock some mysteries of the aging brain.
Hello, welcome. Go ahead, have a seat right here.
Have a seat here, Mom.
Currently, we're diagnosing Alzheimer's with a memory test. By the time you get memory loss, you've already lost 50% of your brain cells. It's very difficult for any treatment to be effective at that point.
But what if you could spot the disease 5, 10, even 20 years before you became symptomatic? Dr. Black says he might have found a way by using the eyes as a window into the brain.
Normally, we do not think of the eye as being an extension of the brain, but during embryonic development, the back of the eye, the retina, actually develops from the brain itself. So it's brain tissue.
One telltale sign of Alzheimer's is a buildup of sticky plaques. They're called beta amyloid. They're inside the brain. They can start to develop years before the first symptoms. And in fact, those same plaques develop in eye tissue as well.
The beauty of that is that it allows us to essentially have a non-invasive, repeatable, high-resolution test to be able to see these protein changes that are the hallmark of Alzheimer's disease very early.